Hello friends, welcome to Texture Diesel. In this video we will learn how to use PIR sensor to detect any motion. As you can see, I can control the room light just by moving my hand. Like that, you can also use the sensor for the security purpose. You can connect the sensor with the security camera or buzzer system. During the video I will discuss all the features of this sensor with a circuit diagram and a practical example. We will see how to use this PIR sensor standalone or with the Arduino. So after watching the video, you will get a complete idea how to use this PIR sensor in your electronics project. If you not yet subscribe our channel, please do subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified for my upcoming videos. So let's get started. This is a PIR module, and you can see it consists of a pyroelectric sensor which generates energy when it exposed to heat. So when any human or animal gets into the range of this sensor, it can detect the motion, as all the living objects like human or animal emit some amount of heat energy in form of infrared radiation. Thus this pyroelectric sensor can sense any movement of an object just by sensing the infrared radiation comes from that object. So this module is also called PIR sensor, the term passive because it not use any energy for detecting purpose. It just sends the heat energy emitted from the other object and sends the movement of that particular object. This module also consists a specially designed cover called Fresnel lens to focus all the surrounding infrared to this pyroelectric sensor. And apart from that, you will find these three pin. This is VCC, this is ground, and the middle pin is the output pin. After it sends any motion, it will give a logic level high at the middle pin. And you will find these two potentiometer at this side. With this potentiometer, we can adjust the delay time from 0.3 seconds to 5 minutes. The output pin will remain high during the delay time after it sends any motion. And with this potentiometer, we can adjust the range or selectivity of this module. The range can be up to 7 meters. And if we come this side, you will find these three pin. If I remove the jumper, this pin is for non-repeatable trigger and this pin is for repeatable trigger. So if I place the jumper with the non-repeatable trigger, then the output pin will remain high only during the delay time when it sends any motion. But if I place the jumper with the repeatable delay time, then the output pin will remain high as long as the moving object within the range of the sensor. So we have discussed all the pins of the sensor. Now we'll connect the sensor with the circuit. As you can see, I have already designed the circuit on this breadboard. But before testing, let's understand this schematic. This video is sponsored by utsource.net, where you can find all the electronics components like resistor, capacitor, transistor, different modules, sensor, ICs at very attractive price. I have also ordered some electronics component from the utsource.net at very reasonable price, and as you can see, you will get a good quality product at very attractive price. For more details, please visit utsource.net, the link given in the description. This is the PIR sensor module, and you can see this is the output pin of the module, which is connected to the base of the BC547 transistor through a 1K resistor. Now BC547 is a NPN transistor, so whenever we give positive pulse to the base of the transistor, the current can flow from collector to emitter as the transistor turns on. So when it detects any motion, the output pin of the PIR sensor become high and the transistor turns on as it receives the high pulse at the base. If the transistor is in on mode, then current can flow through this relay coil to the collector of the transistor and from collector to emitter and emitter to negative terminal of the 5 volt power supply. Thus current can flow through this path, and as current flowing through the coil of the relay turns on, and whatever the load connected across the normally open and common contact of the relay will turn on. In this case, this 230 volt
AC lamp will turn on as it connected across the N1 common contact, as you can see. And whenever the transistor turns on, this LED also turns on with the relay. As you can see, the current can flow also through the LED in this path. Now after the delay time, the output pin of the PIR sensor will become low, so it will not give the positive pulse to the base of the transistor and transistor will turn off. That time no current can flow collector to emitter of the transistor, so current cannot flow through this relay coil as the transistor is in off mode. So the load connected with the relay will turn off and accordingly this LED will also turn off. And we have used this diode in reverse polarity. As you can see, we have connected the cathode of the diode with the positive and anode with the negative, because whenever we turn off the relay, due to high inductance of the coil, it generates a negative pulse which can damage this transistor. So this diode will provide the path for this negative pulse to protect this transistor. It is very important to connect a diode in reverse polarity across the relay coil to protect the transistor. As you can see, I have not yet connected any Arduino with this circuit. After testing this circuit, we will connect Arduino to add some more features to this circuit. As you can see, I have connected a 230 volt and a 5 volt DC supply with the circuit. Now if I move my hand in front of the PI sensor, you can see the lamp turns on. But after some time the lamp turns off, although I am moving my hand, because I have selected the non-repeatable trigger mode. So lamp will turn off after the delay time which I have selected. Now if I place the jumper with the repeatable trigger mode, you can see if I start moving my hand, the lamp turns on and it will remain turns on till the object within the sensor range. So instead of lamp, you can also connect your security camera or other alarm system. So whenever it senses any motion, it will turn on the alarm or the camera, whichever you connect with the relay. Now we will connect Arduino with this circuit and the circuit diagram will be look like this. The output pin of the sensor is connected with the digital pin 5 and the base of the BC547 transistor is connected with the digital pin 10. In the sketch, you can see first we are defining the sensor pin and the relay pin. Then in the voice setup, we are initializing the relay pin as an output and sensor pin as an input. Now whenever the sensor sends any motion, the output pin of the sensor which is connected with digital pin 5 will become high. Now in the void loop, you can see if the sensor pin which is digital pin 5 is high, then we will turn on the relay with the digital write function. As you can see, we have written high. Else if the sensor pin is low, then we are turning off the relay with the digital write function. As you can see, we have written low. So this is very simple sketch. Now we will upload this sketch and test the circuit with Arduino. As you can see, we have connected a 230 volt and a 5 volt DC supply with the circuit again. Now if I start moving my hand in front of the PI sensor, you can see lamp turns on. Now if I stop moving my hand, you can see the lamp will turn off after the delay time. Now again if I start moving, you can see the lamp turns on. And if I stop again, the lamp will turn off after the delay time. This is a very basic project and working of the PIR sensor. You can use this sensor in the different home automation project. In my upcoming video, I will use this sensor with the relay module in my next home automation project. Please do subscribe to get notified for that upcoming videos. And if you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. I will definitely reply to that comment. And if you find this project helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.